बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम टू एवरीवन एंड वेलकम इन कैंप बूस्टर विद द देयर शहजादी। आई वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू विद द न्यू टॉपिक इन कैंप बूस्टर चैनल। ओके, दिस इज द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज बेसिकली फ्रॉम द फंडामेंटल केमिस्ट्री, दैट इज रिलेटेड टू द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट और द बेसिक डेफिनेशंस ऑफ द वेरियस टॉपिक्स ऑन द एटम, मॉलिक्यूल, आयन, ionic mass, atomic mass, and what are different kinds of the definitions we have read or we have just get the understanding about them. In this lecture, we are just understanding about the how to calculate the number of moles and number of particles of the different substances. If anything that is a mass or the number of moles or the number of particles are given to us, we follow the two formulas that are basically, firstly we have to calculate the number of moles and secondly we have to calculate the number of particles. So basically these two relate each other. Same formula can we determine the number of moles and mass of any substance, and by the formula of the number of particles we can also determine the number of moles. Let's move towards the practical implementations of the number of moles and the number of particles. Here are the two formulas about the number of moles and the number of particles. If we have to determine the number of moles, then we will use the formula that is equal to the number of moles is equal to the given mass divided by the molar mass of any substance. Then if we want to determine the number of particles, then we will use the formula that is the number of particle is equal to the Avogadro number is multiplied with the number of moles that we have recently determined from the first calculation of the number of moles. Mole mass calculation, it's a basically mole mass calculation is related to the when the we have to determine the mole and the mass is given in our calculations. This calculation is used for the basically calculation of the number of moles or the mass of a substance in our calculations. Here is a formulas for both of them. If we have to determine firstly the number of moles, then we will use the formula that is the number of mole is equal to given mass divided by the molar mass of a substance. And if we want to determine the mass of the substance from this formula, then we will use this. The mass of a substance is equal to the number of mole is multiplied by with the number of molar mass of that substance. That is basically the molar mass is to calculate the atomic masses of each element in our calculation. Let's take an example. If we have a carbon piece, that a coal is a carbon and weighing its gram mass is 9 gram. How to calculate the number of moles in given sample? We have firstly we have to check that what are the things that are given in our sample solution. Are for example, we have to given only the mass that is the 9 gram, and we have to calculate the number of moles that are the molar mass. We have to check that what is the molar mass. We know the molar mass of a carbon is the 12 gram per mole is the molar mass of the carbon. So let's take the our basic formula, that is the number of mole is equal to the given mass divided by molar mass of a given substance. So put these values into the formula. 9 gram is a given mass and divided by 12 gram per mole, that is basically the molar mass of our sample, that is the coal. Basically it belongs from carbon. So here we can get the 0.75 mole, that is the number of moles of this example, that is the of carbon. Okay, and second calculations is about the mole particle calculations. We have to determine the number of moles, then we have to calculate the number of particles. So for this all we will also use the two formulas. For the basically moles we will using the same formula or the same, only change that is a little bit change of the number of the particles. Number of mole is equal to the given number of a particles divided by Avogadro's number. We know the Avogadro's numbers. What is the Avogadro number? It's equal to the 6.02 multiplied by 10 to raise power 23 atoms or a molecules or a number. Then we have to determine the number of particles, that is equal to the Avogadro number is multiplied with the number of moles. Let's get it clarify with an example. So move. Here is a summary for how to determine the mole calculations and mole mass calculation or mole particle calculations. If we are doing the mole mass calculations, we will take the left part, and if we are taking the mole particle calculations, then we will take the right part. Basically, here is in the center, here is a mole. If we determine the mass of a substance, we will use the formula, that is mole crosses by molar mass. This will give us the mass of a substance. If we want to know the number of moles, then what we will do, it's only the division. Mass is divided by the molar mass. So here we will get the moles, number of the moles of any substance. If we have to determine the number of particles, then what we will do, mole is multiplied by with the number of Avogadro numbers, that is 6.02 multiplied by 10 to raise power 23. Okay, if we want to determine the number of moles, then by using this formula, we will just do this. Number of particles is simply divided by the Avogadro's number. Okay, take an example. Here we have to calculate the number of moles, number of molecules, and the number of atoms present in 6 gram of a water. We are giving the three things: moles, molecules, and the number of atoms. So sample is only given by the mass, that is only the 6 gram. And we know the what is the molar mass of the water, it's 18 gram per mole. Number of molecule, how to determine this? It's given by a formula, that is the given mass divided by the molar mass of a given substance. Our given substance is mass 6 gram, and we divided this to the 18, that is the 0.33 mole. Okay, now for the determination of the number of molecules is equal to their number of moles multiplied with their Avogadro's number. Here the number of moles are what? These are the 0.33. Then we simply multiply this with the 6.02 multiplied by 10 to raise power 23, and we get the number of molecules, that are the 1.98 multiplied by 10 to raise power 23. So these are the number of moles, and the last thing, that is what number of the atoms present in a gram. We have to just determine that this. We know that the number of atoms, how many atoms. Water is a basically molecule, so it's contain the three elements. Three elements, why? Because H2O, it's contain two molecule, are the two atoms of the hydrogen and the single atom of oxygen. This will equals to the three. And with three, we multiply the three with their number of molecules, that are the 1.98 multiplied by 10 to raise power 23. And this will be equal to the 5.94 multiplied by 10 to raise power 23, that are basically the number of atoms. This is how we can calculate the number of moles, number of molecules, and the number of the particles present in any given substance. Here is a short question or a summary, like this exampling, we are taking this. Here are the 3.01 multiplied by 10 to raise power 23 molecules of the carbon dioxide present in a container. Calculate the number of moles and its mass. We will simply use the formula that was for the mole mass calculations. Firstly, we have to determine the number of moles, that is the mass divided by molar mass. And when we are getting now about the molar, simple mass, what we will do, we will divide the moles divided by the molar mass. This will be obtained the molar mass, how is some simple mass of that compound. Okay, I hope you all of you are enjoying my videos. And I have a request to all of you that never forget to subscribe, like, and share my channel or my videos to your friends and your younger sisters, those are studying in the 9th class chemistry. Basically, it's a giving a just a knowledge or an activity that I am performing for all of you, and hopes that you all are enjoying it. Take care of yourself and others. Allah Hafiz.